Well, Didi, under this new agreement, is going to be acquiring all of Uber's assets in China, and that includes the operations, the brand, as well as the data. Investors in Uber are going to get a 20% stake in the combined company, which is valued at $35 billion. In addition to that, Didi is going to invest $1 billion in Uber. And now that both companies have confirmed this agreement, it really does lay to rest the huge competition, the fierce competition, between both of these companies. Both of the companies have been spending billions of dollars in subsidies to try to attract drivers as well as passengers. In fact, Uber has already said that it spent $1 billion every year for the past 2 years in this country. The CEO just posted on Facebook that the profitability element was the reason behind Uber's decision. Now, at the same time, Uber is pulling out of what could be a hugely lucrative market for it. It has a lot of potential. China just changed its regulations, so it made the ride sharing completely legal. But Uber has been struggling to gain market share. And the reason for that is that Didi has been a formidable competitor. It has 80% of the market. And also Didi, in the latest round of funding, raised $7 billion. In addition to Apple as being one of its backers, Didi has the Chinese Sovereign Wealth Fund as a backer. And Didi also just pointed out that now it is the only Chinese company that has all three major tech titans behind it as investors: Alibaba, Tencent, as well as Baidu. So a lot of competition now taken away for both of these companies. Guys?
Eunice, quick question for you, just in terms of understanding antitrust laws in China, or whether there are any. This would obviously combine just about everybody who's in this business. Obviously, the two other big guys became Didi. I mean, this already happened, the first merger, but now there won't be any competition. Is there any worry inside China that policymakers would block something like this, or no?
You know, I was going to look into this as well, but I'm sure that there are regulations and antitrust regulations on the books, but I don't know whether or not this is going to apply for this particular case, because as you had said, there have been lots of different investors, and it's kind of unclear exactly whether or not the regulators are going to try to crack down on this. I mean, there are some other smaller competitors out there, but it's really difficult to say. The other thing, though, about this case that's really interesting is that it's been raising concerns among people in the tech community that this could just be the latest example of a foreign tech company that is going to suffer in this business environment, because it has become more difficult for a lot of foreign tech companies to operate because of the regulations as well as the Chinese policies that tend to favor national champions.
Great. Thank you for that, Eunice. I should note, because I talked to some VC guys, literally, we were just emailing this morning about this. There's now a question. This could be considered a great thing for Uber, because obviously you're not losing money. But in terms of the overall Uber valuation, which was $60+ billion, part of that was contingent on the idea that they were going to have a huge piece of China. As part of this transaction, they'll own a little over 5% in equity, and then they have about 17.7% of a preferred in this combined business. But the other piece of it, interestingly enough, is two of the major investors are BlackRock and Tiger Global in both of them. And there'd been a lot of concern about both of those big investors being involved in both of them. You have to assume today they are happy simply because they're not losing money.
Hey, CNBC fans, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Here you're going to find videos packed with all of the information that you need to be smarter about your finances. You can subscribe by clicking right here and click on all the videos around me or the I right here to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.